Hello everybody, it's Tech Tipster here, and today I'll be showing you how to turn your ODroid C1 into a standalone Kodi XBMC machine using OpenELEC. For this tutorial, we will need a C1 and either an SD card or an eMMC module to install OpenELEC onto. Additionally, for a smooth experience, you'll either need a smartphone, a Linux compatible remote control, or a wireless keyboard to control Kodi. The C1 and all its accessories can be picked up from ameriDroid.com if you are in North America, or head over to HardKernel.com for a list of distributors in other parts of the world. To begin, we'll need to obtain the OpenELEC image from the ODroid forums. The link for this is in the description, and if you haven't created an account here yet, I advise you do so and take a look around. There is a lot of great information available. Once here, you can do some reading and leave a reply to Zalair thanking him for his hard work on this image. Then scroll down and find the images for ODroid C1. Download the latest version, which at the time of this was 5.0.5.0. Once downloaded, it's time to route our image to the SD card. If you're unsure how to do this, follow the annotations on screen choosing your operating system of choice. I have another detailed video which will guide you through and explain this whole process. Now it's time to power up our C1. Connect all your accessories and insert the SD card or eMMC into its slot. For Kodi to function at its best, you will need a network connection. A hardwired Ethernet connection is preferred, but you will have no troubles with a wireless connection either. If you don't have access to this, don't worry. You can still watch all of your media easily with a USB dongle or external USB hard drive. In this video, I'll be using a Wi-Fi dongle so I can show you how to set it up once we load up OpenELEC. If you are trying to decide on a Wi-Fi dongle, I recommend looking for one with a Realtek RTL8188CUS chipset. This has been confirmed to be working by many, and for me it works straight away without any drivers needed. My other USB dongles are for a wireless keyboard and mouse combo, and an 8GB USB drive with some movies loaded on it. Now let's connect the power and load things up. You may have a few restarts on your first boot while system tasks are performed in the background. Just be patient and wait until you see this welcome screen. There is not much to do other than press next. If you are using a wired connection, it should show up at this stage, but our wireless setup will be done soon after. You will have the option to enable Samba and SSH, and I do suggest you leave these options enabled for remote access and file transfer to your device. Once we get to the end of these setup screens, we are done and Kodi is ready to use. Now I'll quickly show you how to enable your Wi-Fi dongle, and then we can have a look at performance. From this screen, head right until we reach the settings menu option. Don't press enter, but instead press down and select OpenELEC submenu option. Press down to go down to network, and then right to access the wireless networks checkbox. Press enter and our Wi-Fi dongle will be active. Now press left to go back to our left menu pane and go down to connections. If all went well and our dongle is supported, you will see your wireless network options here on the right. To connect, simply select your network and press enter to be prompted with a password input. Enter it correctly and we are done. You'll see the ready state here, and after that we can escape out and start watching some movies. Now the most simple and easy way to start watching content with Kodi is by using an external hard drive or USB dongle. The benefit to using this over your TV's media player is that a wide variety of formats can be played out of the box, so we'll never have to worry about converting files. Simply plug in your drive into one of the USB ports, and Kodi will auto-detect the drive in the Videos tab. Open it up, select your video, and off you go. It's that easy. Now Kodi can do a lot of other very cool things as well, so if you are interested in that, make sure you check out my Kodi playlist to see some of the more popular options available to you, and these will all work with your C1. So with that, we are done. Kodi is set up, and we are ready to have complete control over our home media. I'll look at performance of the C1 in a later video, so stay tuned for that. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to leave me a comment and hit the like button, and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks again for watching, and see you soon.